Surviving infidelity. Awakening from a reoccurring nightmare. My wife had an affair 9 years ago. We were able to reconcile and move forward. 6 months ago, as we were laying in bed one morning, he texted her. She said it was out of the blue and told me she would block his number. After some investigative work, I discovered a series of texts between the two over a week-long period. I gave her the benefit of the doubt and didn't press the matter. All seemed good, and future call and text logs didn't indicate any further interactions. Last week, she helped my niece, who was staying for a week, with a phone and Apple ID so she could communicate with her parents. I got up to help the kids get ready for school, and my niece and youngest son were staring in disbelief at some raunchy messages that came through over the shared Apple ID. Lo and behold, her affair was engaging in some not-so-outstanding human skills. She hadn't blocked the number. Months prior, she also changed the wireless billing account password. Three strikes, and I am broken off emotionally from her. I told her it was over and I wanted a divorce. Now I am being made to look like an overreacting oaf because nobody knows the backstory. She is making every effort to reconcile, but I am cold, with good reason. She took serious effort to highlight the fact that I have trust issues. Thank you very much. I can't. She hurt our child, she's hurt me. I'm done, and I don't care how people feel about my perceived behavior. So much for trying to respect a person's faults. Edit. Extracted from a common question this community has. Mostly with why I stayed after what occurred 9 years in the past. I'm cool, I have my confidence in the love of my children. Quite honestly, tonight I thought a lot about why I didn't leave sooner. My answer: she has three children from her first marriage, and I raised them for the last 14 years. If I wasn't there for those kids, they would have suffered an ill-advised upbringing. She wanted to be their friend and never their parent. All the discipline and words of wisdom came from one place, and at 20, 19 and 17, they have expressed what me being in their lives has meant. It's possible they would have been okay, but highly unlikely in my opinion. I wanted to leave, but something inside me said, the kids really needed me. Now for the top comments before the little update. And why don't people know the backstory? I remember when my therapist asked, and why does she get to escape the consequences, whilst you look like the bad guy? I really want my sons to respect women honestly. Small town biases would smash that, I'm certain. Your example shows them how to respect women, not pretending their mother is flawless. The kids only need to know age-appropriate information about why you're separating. Friends and family need to know the full truth. Sometimes they will hold wayward spouse accountable. At worst, they may back off, harassing you to constantly forgive the lies and betrayals. You need to also show your sons how to respect yourself by your example. How to value yourself as a partner and how to have standards. They will model what they see, and if the relationship with their mother is full of lies and pain, they'll repeat in their own lives because they won't know any better. Wishing you the best. I'm really going to chew on this perspective. I like it. Thank you. Let them talk, focus on severing your ties from her. You've already wasted 9 years on this human-shaped trash, waste not 9 seconds more. She's quite scared now. Went as far as deleting her social media accounts and changing her phone number. She has never seen me disconnected. Too little, too late. Edit, I changed my mind on the let them talk thing. I understand wanting to protect your children from the truth. But if friends and relatives are buying her narrative and butting in, then you really, really need to get ahead of the game and set their record straight, with proof if need be. I'm talking scorched earth, napalm bomb the whole comic book story they're writing about you. I would say so, I've never unfelt like this before. Now for the update. After being asked for my side of the story by one of her relatives, I learned that the entire story hasn't been shared. No mention of previous contact with the other guy. No mention of the trove of nudes uncovered. As expected, a victim portrait was painted. So, I shared my side. Now for the next story. I, male 41, don't think I will ever marry again. Don't get me wrong. I have pretty much been a never say never sort of a guy all my life. I have never really dismissed an idea, even if it made no sense in the first place. Show up and follow through has been my motto of sorts. But this is something I will not go through again. To love someone wholeheartedly, to give them everything, to place them above and before you, to be there in sickness and in health, and a couple of near-death illnesses, to be awake all hours of the night nursing them back to health, to give them the benefit of the doubt over and over. To take all the crap they throw at you, to absorb their manipulation, lying, insults, BS, and gaslighting, is something I do not want to put myself through again. To do all that and watch them flush a fully functional and loving marriage down the toilet like a turd is not something I cotton to, at all. To be cheated on by someone you love is the worst thing in life, period. I see a life ahead that revolves around me and my sons. I will see them grow, graduate, move out, go to college, perhaps fall in love and marry. I've had one marriage, they will too. They will explore the world, earn, spend, get their hearts broken, perhaps break a few along the way. One fine day, they might present me with a child of their own. But it will only be to me, and to me alone. There won't be anyone next to me. I've had enough. This life is mine alone. I will not share it with anyone. No one deserves it. Which takes me back to the first paragraph. What soon-to-be ex-wife has done is not just cheat on me, she has changed me. From a person who is willing to give everything and everyone a chance, I have now become a cynic who first carefully evaluates how much is this going to hurt me, before I commit to anything that is remotely new. Which is why I hate her even more now. Cheating was bad enough, her changing me is worse. Now for the top comments. I have followed you since the beginning. How you handled this really should be textbook for all those who have been betrayed. You may not have felt this way, but to us you are a hero. You handled the lawyer, the private investigator and your ex, not to mention stay strong for your kids. As for your ex, minimizing contact with her is by far the best way to handle someone like her. I understand your choice to not get married again. This type of trauma takes a huge amount of time to deal with, and rushing into another relationship would not be advisable. However, it doesn't mean you can't go out and date even if it's a one-night thing. For me, it helped regain my self-worth, but it showed my ex that not only I will move on, but to let her know that what she did to me will not stop me from finding someone far better. Stay strong, my friend. I agree. I have the same feelings and a similar story, but I'm female. I too struggle with how much the betrayal has changed me and my optimism about the future. There is also a real fear of putting yourself out there, because I can't imagine ever getting close enough to anyone to be hurt again. At the same time, the thought of not having any kind of relationship devastates me, but I'm not sure I'll ever be able to trust or open up completely. I often say the only ideal future partner for me would be someone who got screwed over as much as I did. Someone who has been through it would truly not want to ever make someone else feel this way. I hope you, and anyone else who feels this way, eventually gets to the point where they feel hopeful about the future. I'm trying. Prayers and positive thoughts to you. I totally feel you. I was screwed over by my ex-husband of 10 years, together 14 years with 9-year-old sons. What he did was unforgivable in terms of the affair, but the thing that burns the most is how he has shaped my future. I am changed as a person. I approach every single relationship in my life differently. I will also never marry again. Screw that. But it makes me sad that I won't have that long-term companionship, total love and trust thing. I won't be able to watch my babies grow with anyone, marvel at how we made them, be so freaking proud of everything they achieved together. That burns. Precisely. When my kids ask me why other kids have both parents living with them, it just kills me from within. These little angels are my world now, and I would slay dragons for them. But I am helpless when they ask these questions. I'm ahead of you there, two marriages with cheating ending them, now 44. For me, the worst part about it is, twice I have gotten up in front of my family and friends and declared my love for someone and committed till death do us part, and they've cheated. I would feel too ashamed to ever do it again. It's like the little boy who cried wolf. Thinking of our wedding day and going through all those memories makes me feel like such a fool. Really, if it weren't for the thought that my kids might want to see the wedding album one day when they're older, I would have burned it to a crisp a month ago. You have been through a ton. Time to focus on yourself now, I guess. I hope you find happiness. Now for the last story. My, male 29, girlfriend, female 29, of 6 years broke up with me 5 weeks ago. Last week I found out she'd been cheating on me. So, here's a bit of backstory. We met 6 years ago at work and started going out not long after meeting. We ended up having a kid pretty quickly, happy accident, 2 years away we brought our first home with money I inherited from my dad. All seemed well up to this point. So the breakup itself. A week or so into January, we were just done watching TV and about to go to bed. Before we do, she says we need to talk. No one likes hearing this and I immediately freak out. She says she feels like we're drifting apart and never talk anymore. I was very confused about this as we see each other every day and talk all the time. She brought up a few points, some of which were fair, others not so much. We've been engaged for 4 years and she felt like we were never going to get married. Fair point, but we had both agreed to focus on doing up the house and wanted to wait for our son to be a bit older. She wants more kids but felt like I didn't. Not true at all. I don't know why she thinks I wouldn't like more kids, I've always been open to it. She wants to buy a bigger house one day, but thinks I'm too comfortable in our current home. Who doesn't want a bigger house? But at the minute, our current one suits us fine. I don't help around the house enough. This is a very valid point. I've been so lazy the past year, somewhat due to COVID constantly being on my mind. I'm an essential worker. But obviously I can't blame it all on that. I've not been doing DIY around the house as much. The first 2 years in this house, I used all my holiday time to get stuff done, but she's had complaints about everything I've touched. Instead of wasting time and money on doing it myself, I've been saving money to get it done professionally. Plus, with the house never being empty due to COVID, getting DIY done isn't the easiest. I don't make enough effort with her friends. I don't think that was a fair point. Some of her friends I've only met at parties and stuff, some of them haven't been the nicest to me, but I've always made an effort with her best friend. Anyway, after the talk, she sleeps on the couch and in the morning goes to her mom's. She plans to stay a while and packs a few things. I spend the whole day a mess while trying to look after our son. Around 6 or 7 p.m., I get a text saying she's coming home to see our kid and have a talk with me. Obviously I'm nervous. She gets home, I ask if she wants to talk. She says let's talk after, then little one goes to bed. I just ask if we're okay, she says yes. We put our son to bed and have a talk about everything bugging her. She says we're okay but we needed to have that talk, says she might need to still spend some time with her mom. I agree to do better, we hug it out and make up. Watch TV and go to bed. At this point I hadn't slept in over 24 hours, so I'm feeling pretty good and get a good night's sleep. So over the next few days, things seem mostly normal. She spends time with her mom in the evening sometimes, which is fine. I'm still feeling on edge and anxious every time but want to let her do what she needs to do. So one day I'm at work, just about to finish, then I get a text from her asking if I can make my own way home because she's having dinner with her mom. I say okay, I'll meet you at home later. I can already tell something isn't right. I get halfway home and get a gut feeling that there will be a letter waiting for me when I get home. I was right. There was a letter sitting on the bed. A load of her stuff was gone, including her work stuff. The letter said stuff like, I do love you and care about, but I don't know how I feel about you romantically, maybe I'll regret this one day. Stuff like that. I ring her in panic, ask her to come talk with me, tells me things like I deserve better. Says she's sorry. The usual breakup stuff. She pops over to drop her son off, we talk a little but she leaves. The next couple of days I'm a huge mess. I reach out to family and friends, but there isn't a lot they can do with the way things are at the minute. I ask her to come round and talk with me and she does. I ask for a confirmation that she's ending things with me, and she says she thinks it's best to end things for now. This is where I get confused. She ends out relationship but says she doesn't know what she wants and wants time and space to get her head sorted. She says she doesn't want to give me false hope but keeps saying things to suggest we could end up back together. Over the next few weeks, we have a few talks and arguments. All ending in the same sort of we're done, but maybe not forever sort of way. Before I get to the next part, here's some context. I had a phone call from my nan asking if she had met someone else. I said no, there's no way. She's not like that. I've always trusted her, but it put the doubt in my mind. I saw she was up late at night on WhatsApp and was wondering who she would be talking to. Seeing as she said she wanted to be alone right now. I tried not to let it bug me, but couldn't get it out my head. Fast forward to last weekend. I was in a bad place and had to ring 111. I asked her to pick up her son and she did. She got to my place and refused to leave me in the state I was, so she asked her mom to pick up her son. I can understand why she didn't want to leave, but having her there while I was on the phone with 111 was not helping me. I had a moment of weakness and asked to borrow her phone. She let me and I checked her WhatsApp, and there was the confirmation. She'd been cheating on me. I even guessed the guy. I felt so angry and betrayed. I was willing to do anything to fix our family and this whole time she had been lying to me. She refused to call it cheating as they haven't been physical yet. But she admitted to having feelings for him while still with me, which in my eyes is cheating. She starts saying she tried to stop having these feelings for me but couldn't. Said she felt crazy for having feelings for someone she's only talked to through Facebook. I offer her one last chance, I said I'll forget this whole thing and won't tell anyone. All she had to do was say sorry and slow things down. didn't even say she had to stop talking with this guy. Just slow things down. She didn't even want to do that. She said she didn't want or deserve my forgiveness. The next day we have another argument over the phone while I'm walking to her place. I get to hers, I've calmed down and said I'm done arguing. I tell her all the plans I've made to do with or without her, but it all seems to go in one ear and out the other. Haven't really spoken to her since. So that's the story. Any advice would be great because I really don't know what to do at this point. I feel like after all this I shouldn't want her back. But I'd be lying if I didn't say I wasn't sure. How do I move on from this? How do I get used to living by myself? How do I pay a mortgage by myself on a low-paid job? Now for the top advice. Get it out of your head that she's going to come back. It's only going to cause you more pain and prevent you from properly grieving. It's time to admit things are over so that you can mourn that loss and properly move forward. She monkey branched to avoid coming back. But even if she did want to come back, OP, please love yourself enough to never take that bait. There are women that will love you for who you are and won't cheat. There's too little time to waste on horrible partners. 6 years sucks to lose, but it was already spent, sunk cost. I did this with my two wives who treated me like crap. I kept hoping for a better future that would never come. Wasted 12.5 and 13.5 years. Counseling has helped me tremendously, I recommend it to everyone. It's hard to find healthy relationships when you're still reliving your childhood traumas. Hugs OP, you got this. Man, I gotta tell you I feel for you bro. I don't wanna lie to you, it's gonna suck, for a really freaking long time. A girl I absolutely loved cheated on me over a decade ago. I'm married to another wonderful woman I started dating after, and I still haven't completely gotten over it, but it is a ton easier and I don't think of her much anymore. But when I do, I can still feel the pain. I wanted to tell you what I wish someone had told me. Focus on yourself. Think about the things you did wrong in the relationship, not what she said necessarily but the crap you personally feel you did wrong or could have done better, and then forgive yourself for all of it. Don't play the what-ifs, instead, work on those faults. Not just for yourself or your next romantic partner, but for your son. Show him how to have your world utterly destroyed and still have the strength and courage to bounce back a better man for it. I love that you came up with plans and told her what you plan to do, with or without her. Really focus on that and build on it. Get new hobbies, pick up shifts, get another job, find a roommate, stay as busy as you can and grow mentally, physically and spiritually. You have more sleepless nights ahead of you than you can count. The best thing you can do is make sure you're so exhausted when your head touches the pillow that your heart can't convince your mind to keep you awake wondering what the hell happened. You have a reasonable window to mourn the death of your old life, but then you need to get to work on building your new one. As much as it hurts to acknowledge, you know she is. You seem like a genuine guy through the words and emotions you convey. She has taken all the good parts of you for granted, don't make the same mistake. Thanks for the kind words. I have tons of plans to get myself into. Just have to wait for the country to open up first, UK. And that's it for this video guys, if you have thoughts to share, leave a comment below. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe if you like this content. I'll catch you in the next one. Good day everyone.